Hello everyone, myself Bismi Picharian, Assistant Professor at Suresh Gyan Vihar University. Today I am going to discuss about the automated dispensing of the drugs as well as mobile technology in the pharmacy department as well as the patient adherence monitoring. So in this today's class, we are going to learn all the things about the mobile technology, adherence monitoring as well as the automated dispensing of the drugs. So learning objectives of this topic is, this lesson will help the students to understand automated dispensing of the drugs, mobile technology, uses of the mobile in the pharmacy department, as well as patient adherence monitoring also. Learning outcomes. After this lesson, students will be able to describe automated dispensing of the drugs, what is the mobile technology's application in the pharmacy, and adherence monitoring means patient adherence monitoring, how we can do the monitoring of this patient adherence. So first topic is automated dispensing of the drugs. So robots have been used for this automated dispensing of the drugs. Okay, robots have been used in logistics and the distribution for many years, but only recently in pharmacy. So this robot have been used in the logistic and the distribution for many years, but in the pharmacy, these robots are used recently. In 2001, the Audit Commission Spoonful of Sugar report advocate the use of automation to transform pharmacy services. So in 2001, the Audit Commission Spoonful of the Sugar report advocate the use of the automation to transform pharmacy services. And since then, many UK hospitals installed dispensary robots. Okay, after 2001 only, many of UK hospitals, they have installed dispensary robots. Okay, so in the pharmacy field, the robots have been used since 2001. So robots are mainly used in the logistics and distribution for many years in other department, means in other commercial uses. But in the pharmacy department, after the 2001 only, the UK hospitals installed dispensary robots. With the help of the dispensary robots, the medicines we can dispense with the help of this automated dispensing system. We have to enter all the things in the computer only, okay, and the robot will do all the jobs, means searching of the medicines, okay, searching of the medicine, packing of the medicine, labeling of the medicine, and dispensing of the medicine. All the things the robot can do. Okay, we only do the things, means we have to enter all the details of the things, of the medicines, all the things in the computer. Okay, and that robot is connected with that computer, so robot can manage all the things. So after 2001 only, the robots we are using in the hospitals. Pharmacy robots have been shown to reduce the incidence of dispensing errors because the computer never makes mistake. Okay, computer never makes mistake. So that is the only formula. The robot reduces the incidence of the dispensing errors. Okay, and improve the speed and efficiency of the dispensing process also. Okay. And this robot, with the help of the robot, we can improve or we can increase the speed and efficiency of the dispensing process. Okay. And optimize use of the space in the pharmacy. So this robot reduces the incidence of the dispensing errors, improve the speed and the efficiency of the dispensing process, and optimize use of the space in the pharmacy. Robot uses in community pharmacy in the UK is still relatively limited. So in the community pharmacy, robots use is very limited in the UK. However, robots have the potential to handle high volumes of dispensing in community pharmacies. Okay, this usage of the robot in the community pharmacy is very limited. However, the robot have the potential. They have the potential to handle high volumes of the dispensing in the community pharmacies or dispensing hubs. and to release pharmacists to develop and deliver patient-centered service. So this robot have potential to handle high volume of the dispensing in the community pharmacies, but the usage of the robot in the community pharmacy is very limited. As newer, smaller and more efficient machines become available, a robot use in all sectors of the pharmacy is likely to increase. Okay, after 2001, the usage of the robot is very high in the sector of the pharmacy, and newer and smaller, more efficient machines also available in the market for usage in the pharmacy. Similarly, automated methadone dispensing machine. Okay, automated methadone dispensing machine. The example of this machine is Methameasure and the Methadose. Okay, offer accuracy and the efficiency in the laborious methadone dispensing process, and their use is likely to increase, to especially in pharmacies with a high volume of methadone dispensing. So the methadone is also a machine that we are using in the pharmacy for automated dispensing. Okay, so the robot and the methadone we are using in the pharmacies for automated dispensing. The use of electronic ward cabinet is the next level of automation in the hospitals. Okay, the use of electronic ward cabinet. Okay, so there is one electronic ward cabinet is there in the hospital. So that is the next level of automation in the hospitals. These have been shown to provide benefits such as reduced number of the medication error. Okay, so with the help of these computerized machines, we can reduce the medication error. Okay, human can make mistake, but this computer never make mistake. So with that logic, this reduce the number of the medication error. Reduction in number of the missed doses also. Supply delays, okay, also reduce the supply delay, stock outages, and reduction of stock holding and the wastages. So with the help of computerized machine, we can reduce the number of medication errors, reduce the number of missed doses, reduce the supply delay, reduce the stock outage, and the reduction of stock holding and the wastage also we can reduce with the help of the computerized machines. So if you are installing or if you are using any automated dispensing system in the pharmacy, so we suppose to install all the things in the computer first, okay, and that computer is the thing that never make any mistakes. Okay, with the help of that logic, we can reduce the medication error. Medication error is possible if the human is, or if the doctor or if the nurse or the pharmacist giving any medicine, so at that time medication error, chances of the medication error is there. But with the help of the computerized machine, the medication error is reduced. Okay, and also reduction in the number of the missed doses and the supply delays and all the wastage also we can reduce with the help of the computerized machine. So this is all about the automated dispensing of the drug. Means automated dispensing means automatically dispensing. We can dispense automatically the drug to the patient. Okay, means we have to enter all the prescription in the computer, or nowadays electronic prescriptions are available. Means the doctor sent the electronic prescription to the pharmacies, and with the help of that pharmacy, we have to just enter all the necessary things in the computer, and the robot do all the necessary remaining things. Means the robot can read that prescription. Okay, they can search the medicine where the medicine is placed in the pharmacies. Okay, and the robot can take that medicine automatically. Okay, and they can also label that. The robot, with the help of the robot, there is no use. Means we don't do anything. The pharmacist, they don't have to do, means take the medicine, labeling that, means packaging that. Okay, that is not necessary. All the things the robot can manage. Okay, so this is the main benefit of the robot or automated dispensing of the drug. And from 2001, we are using the robot in the pharmacies. And main one thing is that this means we have to enter all the things in the computer, or if the electronic prescription is there, so there is no need to enter all the things. Just we have to enter that prescription and the robot do remaining all the works. And with the help of the pharmacy robot, reduce the incidence of the dispensing error. Dispensing error we can minimize with the help of the robots. And we can also increase the speed of the dispensing process and the efficiency of the dispensing, improve the efficiency of the dispensing process also with the help of the pharmacy robot. And it is also optimize the use of the space in the pharmacy also. So if any pharmacy is using this robot, so that pharmacy don't need means lots of the pharmacists. Okay, because 3 or 4 pharmacists, okay, this robot can do all the works of 3 or 4 pharmacists. So there is nothing need of more staffs. Okay, so this with the help of this pharmacy robot, the pharmacist can reduce the staff also. So economically, this is very useful to the companies. And this robot, the community pharmacy usage of the robot is very limited. Robots have the potential to handle high volume of the dispensing in the community, but this usage is limited, but these robots have the potential to handle lots of dispensing in the community pharmacies or in the dispensing hubs. And release pharmacies to develop and deliver patient-centered services. Newer, smaller and the more efficient machines are available. This robot used in all sector of the pharmacy is likely to increase because of the benefit of this robot. The usage of the robot is very high. Next is mobile technology. Okay. Usage of the mobile telephone is widespread in society. So the usage of the mobile telephone is widely spread in the society. Some pharmacies are using text alerts to remind patients that repeat prescriptions are ready or to offer services, but sophisticated apps have been developed for disease monitoring. Okay, so the usage of the mobile technology. Okay, so we are using mobile telephones nowadays a very high level, means everybody has the mobile phone. So the usage of the mobile technology in the pharmacy is very easy. Okay, so some pharmacies are using text alert to remind the patient for repeat prescription. Okay, if there is any repeat prescription, if any patient is taking lifelong medicine, so they have to take the repeat prescription. Okay, so this pharmacies, they will send the message to the patient for reminding the repeat prescriptions are ready. Okay, or offer any services also, the pharmacies, they will send the message alert. So the mobile technology is very useful for some pharmacies because they can send the text alert to remind the patient for a repeat prescription as well as to offer the services. Okay, if there is any offer, okay, so they can alert to the patient. Okay, means they can send the text messages to the patient through the mobile. So this mobile technology is beneficial for the patient as well as the pharmacies. If patient forgot about the repeat prescription, so the pharmacies can help them to remember or remind the repeat prescription. Okay, because there are lots of lifelong diseases, so there are lots of patients, they are taking the medicines, they are lifelong, so they need the repeat prescription. So this pharmacies, they are using the mobile phone, they are using the text alert, okay, with the help of the mobile phone to remind the patient that repeat prescriptions are ready or to offer the services. Some sophisticated apps have been developed for disease monitoring also. Means disease monitoring means BP machine is available, diabetes means if you want to check the blood sugar level, so there is a diabetes checking means blood sugar checking machine is also there. So there are lots of sophisticated apps, means some apps are also developed for disease monitoring, because we can check the blood glucose level from some apps, or we can check BP, blood pressure, with some apps. We have to install that app in our phone and we can check regularly. And some wrist watches are available to check all the heartbeats, pulse rate and all the things. Just the thing is, we have to connect that wristwatch with the mobile phone, means we have to install one app in the mobile phone and connect that watch in the mobile phone, and we can measure all the disease, means we can measure the heart rate, we can measure the pulse rate. Okay, so all the things we can measure through a through one wristwatch. So some apps have been developed for monitoring the disease. So this mobile phone is very useful for means useful in the health sector to provide all the guidance to the patient, and the patient is also patients are also taking the benefit of these apps. Okay, so this is the mobile technology. Okay, we can use this mobile for the for a repeat for send the for sending the message to the patient for repeat prescription, as well as for offering any means to offer any services to the patient. Also, we can use the mobile phone. So, for example, recording of peak flow readings in the asthma. Okay, so this is an example of some apps. Okay, some sophisticated app that have been developed for the disease monitoring. So some examples means recording of the peak flow readings in the asthma. Okay, so that is also possible with the help of the mobile. Monitoring of the blood glucose level. So I have told monitoring the, we can measure the blood glucose level with the help of the app we have to install from the Play Store. Medication adherence support and health education is also possible with the help of the mobile. We have to install the apps. These apps will have a greater impact on the pharmacy practice in the future. Okay, so these all the apps will have a greater impact on the pharmacy practice in the future. So we can record the peak flow readings in the asthma with the help of the mobile phone. Just we have to install that app in our mobile phone and we can record the peak flow reading. And we also monitor, we can also measure the blood glucose level through the phone itself. Okay, so these all are the examples of the sophisticated apps that we have to install in our mobile phone means for disease monitoring and all the things. So we have to know what is adherence. Okay, so we have to know what is adherence. Adherence is generally described as the extent to which patient takes medicines, okay, as prescribed by their healthcare providers. Okay, so if any lifelong medicine taking patient, they will stop any medicine after 1 week of that prescription. So what happens? So that is a life threatening to the patient, because the medicine means lifelong medicine means the medicine the patient, they will have to take the medicine lifelong. Okay, means if any patient stop the particular medication, okay, without any guidance of the healthcare provider, so that is the life-threatening, or that will be very costly too. Okay, so adherence is the thing to means the extent to which the patient takes medicines as prescribed by their healthcare providers. Okay, if regularly they are taking the medicine, so that patient is very adherence to the medicine. But if the patient is not taking the properly, so that is non-adherent. Okay, so adherence, it is generally described as the extent to which patient take medicines as prescribed by their healthcare provider. Okay, so that is, so this patient adherence is very important factor to treat a particular disease. Okay, if anybody or if any patient is not taking the medicine properly, so that is very costly as well as very life-threatening also. So how we can monitor the adherence of the patient? Okay, so there are several ways to monitor medication adherence. Okay, so first one is medication event monitoring system. Okay, medication event monitoring system, that is known as MEMS, medication event monitoring system. So these are the most accurate method of measuring adherence because they record the date and the time the medication bottle was opened through the microprocessor technology embedded in the cap. Okay, so this medication event monitoring system is the system in which we can install a microprocessor in the cap. Okay, and when the patients open that particular bottle, so the date and time will be recorded. Okay, so this is the accurate method of measuring adherence because they record date and time of the medication bottle was opened. Okay, through how they can record? Through the microprocessor that is in the cap, that is embedded in the cap. Microprocessor embedded in the cap, through that microprocessor we can record the date and the time the medication bottle was opened. So this is the method we can measure all the time, or we can record the time and the date through the microprocessor technology that is embedded in the cap. So next is, let's see the advantages and disadvantages of this microprocessor. Errorness, not faithful, because patient may remove more than one dose. Okay, so this is in the hand of the patient, so they can remove more than one dose. So if they removed more than one dose, so that also recorded in that particular microprocessor. So this, there is chance of the error, and not to faithful because the patient may remove more than one dose. So this is one disadvantage of this MEMS. Next is, it is very expensive. Okay, it is very expensive, and different devices are needed for each medication. Okay, so this microprocessor technology is very expensive, and different devices are, means different microprocessors are needed for each medication, through which only we can record the time and the date. And therefore, it is impractical way to determine adherence in the clinical practice. So because of that reason, because this is very expensive, so everybody can't afford this, okay? Because the medication cost will be very high if we are using this microprocessor technology, okay? So that is the thing. It is very impractical way to determine the adherence in the clinical practice. Otherwise, this have one advantage. We can record the date and the time of that bottle opened. Okay, so there are lots of disadvantages. Because of that reason, this method is not used. Okay, sorry. Second is patient self-report. Patient self-report. Patient self-report is the easiest method when adherence is being assessed. Okay, so the patient self-report is very easiest method because this is very cheap. Open-ended questions should be asked. Okay, there are two types of the questions we have discussed in the computer application subject. There are two types of the questions, open-ended question and the closed-ended questions. Okay, so in the self-report, patient self-report, the healthcare providers or the health center, they have to ask open-ended questions. Instead of asking, are you taking your medication? Are you taking your medication is closed-ended question because the answer must be in yes or no. Okay, so that is closed-ended question. So we have to ask the open-ended question to the patient. The HCP should phrase the question along the lines of how many times in the past week or the past month have you skipped your medications. Okay, if that patient skipped any medication in the past week, so he have to write in that particular report, means I have skipped or I have forgot to take the medicine two times or three times or four times in the past week or in the past month. So the healthcare center Okay, healthcare center, they have to ask open-ended question rather than the closed-ended question, means yes or no. And the question that are coming in, means the answer of that question, that should be long. Okay, so that is the open-ended question. So the patient self-report is very easiest method to ask the questions. Next is pill count. Pill count means we have to count the pill. If 30 days in a month, okay, if 30 days in a month and the healthcare provider, they provide means the 30 tablets to the patient. Okay, after the 15 days, if the patient comes to the healthcare provider or to the doctor, so they can count or the pharmacist can count how many tablets the patient had taken. Okay, so that is the pills count. Next is pharmacy database or the refill rates. Okay, pharmacy database means the patient, means the pharmacy, they have to maintain the prescription details or the patient details in their computer, means there's a one database. So all the patient details, okay, all the patient details, how many tablets or how many medications are given to that particular patient, all the things they have, the pharmacy have to maintain. And the or prescription, refill prescription date is also maintained by the pharmacy. So with the help of that repeat prescription, okay, we can measure the patient adherence. Okay, and next is blood levels, which also are employed in the research, are more feasible option for the clinical practice. Okay, if we want correct patient adherence, we have to follow this method. Blood level, okay, checking the blood level. Okay, if lifelong medication taking the patient, okay, that when he or she will come to the healthcare provider, so they can check the blood level to monitor the patient adherence. Okay, to monitor the patient adherence. So this is the one, means this is a very feasible option. It is very feasible and easy option for checking the blood level. Means if any patient is taking any cardiovascular, means if I say any cancer drug, okay, anti-cancer drug or anti-neoplastic drug, okay, so the healthcare provider, they will give all the details of the medication, means how many times they have to take in a day, okay. And after that, if the patient is properly taking that medication, so the means amount of the drug that is present in the, that should present in the blood, is the main thing. With the help of that amount of the drug, we can measure how much that patient is adherence, or means they have adherence or not. Okay, patient adherence is measured by the blood level, okay, by checking the blood level. Then next is Moriski's medication adherence scale. Okay, Moriski's medication adherence scale, that is MMAS. It was designed to distinguish poorly adherence patient from those with medium to high adherence to their antihypertensive regimen. So what is this? It was designed to distinguish poorly adherent patient from those medium to high adherence patient. So this is the MMAS. MMAS consists of questions addressing multiple reasons for non-adherence. Okay, so in this MMAS, there are lots of questions, and that means addressing multiple reasons for non-adherence. Example, because regimen complexity can lead to the non-compliance. Okay, so this MMAS consists of lots of questions addressing multiple reasons for the non-adherence. Okay, so the scale contains the question assessing whether the patient feels hazzled about his or her regimen. Okay, so the scale of the scale contains a questions assessing whether the patient feels troubled or tensed about his or her regimen. Since patients tend to give their positive answer to please them, okay, if means that scale of that means particular Moriski's questions. The questions are like means whether the patient feels trouble or tense about his or regimen, and since the patient tend to give their positive answers to please them, okay, by themselves also. The questions in the Komorowski studies were phrased to avoid this bias. Okay, means the Komorowski study, and means in that the Komorowski study, there are questions that is phrased to avoid this type of the mistakes. Okay, each question measures a specific medication taking behavior rather than the adherence or the compliance behavior. Okay, so in each question in the Komorowski study, they measure a specific medication taking behavior rather than adherence or compliance behavior. So this is the example of the Komorowski medication adherence scale. So let's see, in this Komorowski medication adherence scale, there is one, do you sometimes forget to take your high BP pills? So the first question is like this. Then next question, over the past 2 weeks, were there any days that you did not take your high BP medication? So if any patient, they will answer like this, means yes or no. If any patient means answer like this, no, I haven't forgot any medicine to means a high BP pills medication. Okay, and then next question is, over the past 2 weeks, were there any day that you did not take your BP medication? Okay, so if he or she mentioned yes, I have forgot to take medicine on the Friday or on the Thursday, so he or she will mention here. How have you ever cut back or stopped taking your medication without telling your doctors because you felt worse when you took it? Okay, so this is another similar question to this. Okay, so the patient will answer like this, yes, when I took that medication, then I felt means like I had nausea or I had headache. So he or she mentioned that all the things here. So look at these three questions. The three questions are similar, means same questions are there, but the phrases of these questions will be changed here. So this is confusing questions to the patient. So they will answer accordingly. So from that answer, the healthcare center can recognize or can measure all patient adherency. Okay, so this is the one of the most important patient adherence monitoring. Okay, so Komorowski medication adherence scales, all the questions are almost similar, but they can measure the patient adherence, okay, medication adherence according to their answers. Healthcare is rapidly adopting new technologies to integrate data analytics for providers and streamline processes within the medical practices and help patients better manage their health. Okay, so healthcare sector, they are adopting new technology for integration of data analytics. Okay, for providing the patient a better health also, they are adapting. Okay, they are adopting new technologies, okay, to providing a good health to the patient. With new digital innovations being introduced daily, it is now possible for consumers to better manage their own health and the wellness through their portal device, assessing medical information, tracking their daily health, and even monitoring their vital signs. Okay, so there are lots of digital innovation they're being introduced daily. Okay, digital innovation being introduced daily. So it is now possible for consumers to better manage their health. Means the each and every person, they can manage their own health with the help of this digital innovation. Okay, health and wellness through their portal device, assessing medical information, as well as that digital innovation or that all the things, they track their daily health as well as even monitoring their vital signs also, because means I have told means there is one risk was that we have to connect it with the mobile phone. In the mobile phone, we have to install particular app, and that the wristwatch and the apps will connect it to each other, and they can measure all the heart rate, pulse rate, all the things. Okay, so with the help of this type of the digital innovation, the consumer or the patient or each and every person in the world, they can manage their own health. seeing this transformation not only in specialty pharma, specifically pharmacy, but healthcare as a whole, researchers performed a pilot study to see the influence of the SMS mechanism, because we are talking about the mobile technology here. So performed a pilot study of to the influence of the SMS, means SMS short message services, are more commonly called text messaging, on adherence in the specialty population, specifically related to the refill rates, because the pharmacies, they will send the message to the patient for the prescription refill. Okay, prescription refill, repeated prescription, they will send the message to the patient, or they will, if means they will send the message for to provide the offer services also. Their hypothesis was the bi-directional SMS technology will improve patient and the clinician engagement, resulting in increased medication adherence. Okay, if the message and bi-directional means both side SMS sending, okay, sending the message in the both side, means the hypothesis is that the patient sent to the message to the clinical pharmacy and the clinical pharmacy sent the message to the patient. So that is the bi-directional SMS. So that will improve, that technology will improve the patient as well as the clinician engagement, and that increase the medication adherence also. After evaluating 94 patients, they saw a significant positive impact on the refill date. Okay, if the patient and the clinician, they will talk to each other, so that will increase the patient means patient adherence. So that is the, yeah, the researchers, they are evaluated 94 patients, means they adapt this method for the 94 patients, and they will increase, okay, they will positively increase their patient adherence to the medication. Okay, what does this mean for the patient? Means easily manage refills to ensure medication doses are not missed. So with the help of the SMS, okay, they can manage refill to ensure medication dosage are not missed. Taking ownership of healthcare and being in better control of health outcomes. Okay, taking ownership of the healthcare and being in better control of health outcomes. Avoid unnecessary trips to the doctor. Okay, if the patient and the clinician, they will talk to each other through the SMS, so that avoid the unnecessary trip to the doctors or even the hospital due to the non-adherence. Okay, so this is the thing, benefit of the SMS mobile technology for the adherence of the medication adherence to the patient. So in this pandemic scenario, this method is very useful, because the patient can avoid the trips to the doctor as well as in the hospital also. So in this pandemic situation, this is very beneficial. Okay, and what does this mean for the patient? What does this mean for the provider? Patient can more easily manage their own medication, saving your practice time and the resources. Okay, the patient can manage their own medication. Okay, so that save the practice time and the resources. Better communication with their specialty pharmacy and the prescription updates and the reminder. So better communication takes place, okay, with the help of this mobile technology. Improved patient health through increased medication adherence. Okay, so increased, due to the increased medication adherence, the patient health is also will also improve. So this is the mean for the providers. In order to help improve patient health and the increased medication adherence, researchers have built in a text messaging component to their mobile app. Okay, so there is one mobile app. Okay, so the researchers built a text messaging component to their mobile app. For any patient who download that mobile app, they have access to refill their prescription. Okay, so the researchers, they built a mobile app. Okay, if any patient who wants to download that mobile app, okay, so if any patient download that mobile app, they have access to refill their prescription, receive prescription updates, set medication reminder, and manage their doctor information. So there are lots of apps are available for doing this all the duty, because if any patient install that particular app. So through with the help of that with the help of that app, they can receive the prescription update. Okay, they can set the medication reminder and manage their doctor information also. So this is the this app or this mobile technology is very useful for the patient. With the proliferation of the smartphone, mobile healthcare solution have started to play an increasingly important role in the pharmaceutical market. Okay, so proliferation of the smartphone, okay, mobile health, that is mHealth solution have started for the pharmaceutical market. mHealth is a relatively recent development and has the potential to help the foster a more efficient healthcare system. So this mHealth, mobile health is very popular and very useful in the healthcare system. The concept or this concept is especially relevant given the greater focus on implementing a value-based delivery model. A pharmaceutical industry has responded by utilizing new technologies to help facilitate the patient-doctor relationship and the bolster patient engagement. Okay, so this mobile technology is very useful for the patient as well as the doctor to prescribe all the medications, all the things. mHealth means greater attention can be placed on encouraging the patient adherence to treatment plans through the use of the mobile application. Okay, so here we are talking about the patient adherence, patient medication adherence with the help of the mobile technology. This mobile technology or mobile health means increase the patient adherence to the treatment plans through the use of the mobile applications. It may also assist in improving the result of the patient reported outcomes, PROs, and the promoting health and the wellness. Okay, so this type of the mHealth apps, okay, they will improve the result of the patient reported outcomes and promote the health and the wellness. At the same time, pharmaceutical companies are looking for the ability to better analyze and leverage their data with the aim of the incentivizing patient adherence and the increasing revenue. So with the help of this mobile technology, they can increase their revenue also. mHealth can also improve preventive care. Okay, so this mHealth app can improve the preventive care. Patient, for example, can use mobile technology to better manage long-term conditions such as diabetes and the hypertension. So this diabetes and the hypertension are the disease. They have, mean diabetic patient or the hypertensive patient, they have to take the long, means lifelong medication. So this lifelong medication, okay, lifelong medication is also, they can manage very easily with the help of the mobile phone. Okay, so the patient, for the example, can use mobile technology to manage their long-term medications such as diabetes and the hypertension. Weight loss, there are lots of weight loss applications are there that record caloric intake, and the fitness application that measure the calories burned during the workouts are two such examples. Okay, there are weight loss applications available. They record the caloric intake and the fitness application that measure the how much calorie they burned during the workout. Mobile application capable of monitoring blood glucose levels are serving as useful aids for the diabetic as well. So the mobile application capable of monitoring the blood glucose level, okay, means useful aids for the diabetic as well. These developments can enable pharmaceutical marketers to improve brand awareness by supporting consumers who are taking steps to proactively improve their health outcomes. So this mobile technology is very beneficial for the patient as well as the pharmaceutical company also. Mobile can also assist the public education awareness campaign. Okay, this is necessary in an interconnected world where the ability to identify the geographic location of a rapidly spreading illness may prevent hospitalization and save lives. Okay, so this also mobile technology we can use for the assisting the public education awareness campaign. Patients and the doctors in developing countries have been quick to embrace mobile technology, making it easier for pharmaceutical companies to reach traditional underserved populations. Okay, so patient and the doctors in developing countries, they both are using the mobile technology for making their life easy. challenges to mHealth adoption. So this is the drawback. Challenges to mHealth adoption include security concern, the regulatory uncertainty. So there is a security concern in the mHealth because all the data, they can be public. Okay, so mHealth system tend to be fairly open and operate in a variety of the computer networks, leading to vulnerabilities associated with the identity protection and the sensitive behavioral information. Okay, so this is the main drawback of this mHealth. So this is all about the patient adherence monitoring, mobile technology, all the things. Okay, so let's see some MCQs regarding this topic. So robot have the potential to handle high volume of dispensing. So correct answer is dispensing. Meaning of the medicine adherence is taking medicine properly. Is the correct answer taking medicine properly is the medicine adherence. Method of MEMS is through microprocessor technology. So one microprocessor is attached in the cap. So MEMS is through microprocessor technology. Correct answer is B. What is the use of the mobile technology? Medication reminder, prescription refill, for monitoring the blood glucose level, all of the above. So the correct answer is all of the above. Which is the easiest way to monitor the adherence? So the correct answer is patient self-report. Okay, through the patient self-report, we can monitor the adherence. So this is all about this topic and this is the reference. So I hope everybody understood it very well. So thank you.